Lights, camera, action. Oh, for outrageously awesome. Let's go to our host for the opening ceremony, Wendy Petrie and Andrew Saville.
This grand old lady of New Zealand sport has seen some magnificent battles over the years, but tonight is going to be something very, very special. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
And the countdown is
for
on.
New Zealand. We await the countdown.
Here we go. The sky is lit up with stars on this glittering night at Eden Park, the opening ceremony of the Rugby World Cup.
First of all, we begin with the call, to be followed by the journey, the battlefield, and finally the prize.
Here, calling the chiefs and champions to gather together. Promised a dazzling video projection technology not seen on such a scale before in New Zealand, and that's exactly what we're seeing.
Here's the field in front of us, covered in a projection surface covering about 100 metres by 70. For this superb light show.
New Zealand reaching out to the world.
We now have the journey in the opening ceremony, and how apt that sails descend on Eden Park. This is the city of sails, the nation of sails, New Zealand.
And from the city of sails, we see the boats gliding across Eden Park in a spectacular sea of black and white, capturing the essence of travel and adventure.
Thank you.
1,000 performers from all over New Zealand who have been rehearsing for many, many weeks on this performance.
So the 8 small boats signifying the ocean voyages many made to come to this great land are now joined by 2 sailing ships. The voyagers have arrived on the sailing ships.
Now these 2 large boats are 10 metres long and 10 metres high. They're the largest props in the show.
So 250 volunteers in this segment of the ceremony itself, over 1,000 involved in the ceremony tonight. Just shimmering below the surface.
Mongopare sharks, hammerhead sharks, they form an integral part of the Rugby World Cup 2011 brand identity. The motive has been adopted based on the tendency of mongopare to hunt together in packs, which is rare for sharks.
There's that distinctive motive, Wendy. On the rugby balls to be used during the tournament, volunteers' outfits to the artwork around this country.
We can see the boats have transformed into sharks, into these mongopare sharks, by reclining backwards to form dorsal fins. Symbolising team mentality and aggressive stance linked to the animal kingdom, to the world of rugby.
Hammerheads collide and the power of the call is released.
Now we move on to the challenge and the haka.
Go!
Well, the challenge, the haka, the challenge has been laid. A stirring challenge from Te Matarai e Oraho, the grand champions of Kapa Haka for 2011.
We now move to the backyard, the metaphor for the game of rugby. And a young boy races onto the field carrying his precious souvenir, the Rugby World Cup 2011 ball, scoring his first try.
And Wendy wearing the great number 11,
and
worn by so many great
and the jersey
players over the years.
The Canterbury colours. Special tribute to Christchurch. Are the Gladiators. They play by volunteer rugby and sports enthusiasts from all around Auckland, trained for this for several months.
So the one boy in 11 against 100 Gladiators.
Very talented boy, Ethan Bai, will no doubt be a star by tomorrow.
This really does signify the backyard rugby that so many of us around the nation played as children, and Ethan doing a wonderful job. This really is a magnificent lighting show, video and choreography. Months, years in the planning. Around the country, yes, Wendy, and this is a moment he will never forget.
With the Gladiators, pick up the rookie and use him as a substitute. Up he goes. What a visual spectacle. Computer-generated graphics. Very impressive.
Forget young Ethan, suspended 20 metres above the ground.
Now we take a look back at some historical rugby images from the late 19th, early 20th century, sourced from an archive that had been really seen before tonight.
the young boys walking across some of the great names of world rugby, and there is one of the greatest of all about to be revealed. And it is
Gospel Christchurch, my friend.
The one and only Jonah Lomu.
Scoring more tries than any other player in the world. In a World Cup tournament.
Yes, Jonah still leading across all World Cups as the top try scorer with 15. And now this gigantic replica of the William Webb Ellis Cup makes its way onto the middle of Eden Park.
Jonah saying, do it for Christchurch. Special tribute tonight for Christchurch.
And now the anthem we've become so used to hearing at World Cups. Since 1991, World in Union.
And a unique interpretation of the official tournament song. The combined talents of over 400 singers.
Rendition of World and Union, a real Pacific Island feel to it, the rearrangement. The lead singer there, Rhea Hall, with Evander, Folau. ukuleles, log drummers, superb.
We now move to the Rugby World Cup Haka.
Our thanks go to Rugby New Zealand 2011, the New Zealand Rugby Union, and the New Zealand Government for their vision, dedication, and hard work. Our special thanks go to the many volunteers. Without them, this magnificent event would not be possible. I would like to wish all of the teams the very best, and to everyone here and around the world, enjoy all that Rugby World Cup 2011 has to offer. And now, it's my honour and privilege to declare Rugby World Cup 2011 in New Zealand officially open.
Prime Minister John Key and Chairman of the International Rugby Board, Bernard Lapasset.
Well, we were promised a night to remember, and it certainly is. Spectacular opening ceremony.
And narrow wait for the biggest pyrotechnic display this country has ever seen. And if the opening ceremony is anything to go by, this is going to be a truly unique Rugby World Cup and a magnificent Rugby World Cup for the whole nation to enjoy. Downtown Auckland, about to be lit up by this multi-million dollar fireworks display. Auckland's Viaduct Harbour.
Absolutely full to this.
Sure have, Wendy. Every vantage point around the city taken from about 2 or 3 o'clock this afternoon. Not to mention the 60,000 wedged into Eden Park for the All Blacks v Tonga.
Hara Maira, Hara Maira.
wonderful way to finish what has been a very special Rugby World Cup opening ceremony.
What an evening.
Yeah.
street, wrapped up in grey. Turn down the heat, try to get through the day.
Standing by as a special guest, Jonah Lomu will be in the studio very shortly.